Welcome guys to my first YouTube video ever, and I want to apologize because my English is not so good, and I hope you will not judge me because of this and enjoy the video. So I want to introduce you to a new game named Dragon Tamer. What it's about and what you can do, something like that. So first of all, you can, we have two server, Genesis and Yggdrasil. As you can see, my main account is Genesis, and my baby account is on Yggdrasil, so we play on Genesis. So, every loading bar, under every loading bar we have some tips, like gold can be collected from habitats. That will help you in the game to go on and get some tips from what you can do if you don't know what to do, how you can get better. In something like that. For the pros, it's not that helpful because they already know what to do, and yes. As you can see, that's one of my islands, that's the second island, that's the third island, fourth, I don't know what's the fifth and sixth. Yeah, but I think this is the fifth, and this is the sixth. I don't know. Okay, but going on. What is the game about? It's about dragons. It's like Monster Legends or Dragon City. And you can breed dragons, you can hatch them, you can level them up, you can collect gold, you can collect food. The food is needed to feed your dragons to level them up. So, yes. First of all, the dragons. The dragons. Have 5 tiers, like common, uncommon, rare, epic and legendary. As you can see, it gives 69 dragons in this game. For the common, it gives 6 dragons, and as you can see, 6 elements, like nature with blades, fire with raging fire, water with Trixie, thunder with thunder, earth with dust, and the last one, iron cap with metal. So, in this common, this common dragons are the basic dragons, because you can get them easily from the shop. At the right corner here, you can go shop and then click on dragons, and you can buy them for some gold. But you will unlock them at a certain level, like. I think Iron Cap is at level 29, but I'm not sure. And you need gold to buy them, like 1000 for blades, 2000 for Raging Fire, 10000 for Trixie, 100000 for Thunder, and so on. Yeah, that was the common category. Now we go to uncommon. I will tell in a later video how you get all the dragons. I will do it like I will introduce them in a separate video, what they can do, what skills they have, and something like this. That's now you can see blades, what stats he has, like HP C tier, crit D tier, speed D tier, defense D tier, attack D C tier. And crit is not how much crit damage you do. It's crit hit, so the chance to crit on the enemy. As you can see, every dragon has 3 skills. It doesn't matter which tier. You can go to legendary tier and like click on unicorn, 3 skills. So this dragon blades has 3 skills, and as you can see. It's on the, if you click on the, it's named collection book, it says, it shows the stats at the max level. You can level them up later on in the training room. If you go to train, you can level up the skills of this dragon. So, go back to blades, as you can see, 3 skills. The first skill, as you can see, Razor Leaf marks the max level, and is the timer, it's a clock with a 0 in it. The second skill has a clock with a 2 in it, and the third again. What does this mean? It means that you can use the first skill how much you want. You can spam it over and over in the battle, but the second and third skill has a cooldown. You need 2 rounds to use this skill again and this skill again. I don't know if I can find. Yes, here. Here it says 0 0 cooldown, 1 cooldown, 1 round cooldown, and 3 round cooldown. So you need to know this because it's a strategy which skill you can use in the battle and what is important to use. Like if you have a legendary, because I have a unicorn, he has a heal, and if you use this heal too early, you can't use it for 2 rounds, and that's important to know how to use the skill and what you can what strategy you use. So going on, if you want to level up your dragons, like blades, you can use food. I have 3.5 million food, and I need 8,500 food. And if I go and level up, you see the base stats change. Now I have 4,108, and if I level him up to 23, it goes up to 4,366 HP. And if you go up with the tier of the dragons, like the legendary tier, you can see Hades has other tier stats, like HP is on B tier, crit is on B tier, speed is on A tier, defense is on A tier, and attack is on S tier. And S tier is the max tier right now in this game. We don't know if it gives like SS tier in the future. Maybe it's possible, but we don't know. Yes, and it's okay, it's a legendary, so it's of course it's right that we have S tier in my best stats, like not as the common tier. Yeah, where can you use the strengths and why do you need to level them up and feed your food to them? First of all, collect my food, sorry guys. So, where can you use the strengths? You go to combat. You can use them in the adventure, arena, space time rift, mystic mountain, and forest of spirits. The adventure, it's like in every other game, adventure mode. You have, if you go to map, if I go to the normal mode, I can't play it again because I've cleared it already. It would be good if you can do it again. So if you have already at the master mode, it's the last mode, because it's normal mode, hard mode, and so on. Yes, but go back to the battle. If you click combat, you can see against what dragons you fight. You can do strategy, which dragon you use to counter this dragon. As you can see, like fairy, the middle dragon, the epic, the level 35 dragon in the middle, it's a healer, so you need some dragons like where is Wayne, because he can stun the enemies. So if you are not like, if your dragons are like level 25 and you're already in the in this hard mode, it's good to have a dragon that can stun the enemies, so you have a second round and can attack them again and they can't do anything. So this is one part you can use your dragons. Then in the arena, as you can see, we only have the competitive arena. We don't know if it's come like a live arena where the fighting is live, because right now it's against the AI, and we Don't know if you have friendly battles, like you can fight against your friends and test some combinations of your drinks. But first, let's go to the competitive arena. As you can see, that's the ranking right here on the left side. As you can see, Wild is the rank first, then Kelly, and then Sol. As you can see, defense. First of all, you need a defense, so if you get attacked from some enemies, from some other players, you need drinks that will defend this attacker, and you can win points, but I will say it later. As you can see, I have this drink in my defense, because they are the best drinks I have, except for I can exchange this drink, this core, I can exchange it, because it's, I don't want to do it because he is a tank. He can give a shield to my drinks. Okay, then we go to Record. In the middle of this, as you can see, I get attacked once by Dragon Tamer. And yes, I lost. Yeah, I lost 40 points out of this. That's why it's important to have a defense that can win if you can win against the enemy. And the prizes. What prizes do you get? Daily prizes and season prizes. Daily prizes, you get it every day at the, yeah, I don't, at, I think it's 0, so at 12 p.m. And the season prizes every week at, it's, yeah, for Monday. It's also from Sunday to Monday, you can get this season prizes. And if you want to fight, you can go to combat and look what defense, if you click on the profile picture, what defense the, okay, it doesn't work, okay. No, as you can see, I clicked on Alpha Predicting 1, yes, and I can see his defense lineup, and so you can have again a strategy how to fight against them. Now the space time rift. The space time rift is where you can get dragon bands, but I will tell you in a later video what is this is about, what you can do with this dragon bands. But for now, you can go to fire. It gives a fire rift today. Tomorrow I don't know what it is. It will change every day. And as you can see, it gives 15 rifts. And if you go up, every time you will get better dragon bands. It gives from common to mythic tier brands. Whatever, like I said, I will tell you in another video what it is about. Mystic Mountain. As you can see, the Mystic Mountain is a mountain, and you can you need to beat the stages to beat the stages to get up to the top. It gives 12 stages. We don't know, like I said in the adventure, if you get more stages. If you go to chest, you can see get a Mystic Mountain chest for every 3 stages cleared. So if you beat every 3 stages, this is house and the boss stages, you get a chest. If you click on view, you see what you will get out of the chest. It's really good what you get, but I will tell you in another video what you can do with the Sphinx in the game. And last but not least, the Forest of Spirits. I can't show you what it is about because it's in a, it has a cooldown right now, 1 day and 11 hours. 11 hours, sorry. yes, it you can fight 5 days, but I'm not sure. Yes, I'm sure. 5 days in this Forest of Spirits, and it has a 2-day cooldown before the next Forest of Spirits begin. So I can't show you what it is about. I will show it. I will show you it in the next video if I can show it to you in 1 day and 11 hours. Yes. So that's the first impression I want to give you, and I hope you enjoyed the videos. We will see us next time. Ciao guys!